Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss about laryngeal cavity and pyriform fossa. Now before starting the demonstration, let me give you an orientation about this specimen. So this is posterior view of the larynx, this is laryngeal inlet, this is epiglottis, this is dorsum of the tongue. So this is basically a posterior superior view, and if you see it from in front, see over here, this is lower jaw, portion of mandible is there. This is the dorsum of the tongue, and if you see it from below and in front, and this is how it looks like. So this is again part of mandible, and this is the suprahyoid part, this is hyoid bone. Okay, you can see body of the hyoid bone, and in its continuation you can see this is the greater cornu on either side, and this is infrahyoid part. Now these two are lamina of thyroid, so obviously this will be the thyrohyoid membrane. Okay, now below to that, over here will be cricoid cartilage, and still below you can see these two are lobes of thyroid gland connected by isthmus, and this is part of trachea. You can clearly see tracheal rings. So this is from in front how it looks like. Now the main thing what we are intended to discuss is the laryngeal cavity and pyriform fossa. Now this is dorsum of the tongue, and this will be the posterior 1/3 of the tongue, and posteriorly you can see this is epiglottis. So in between these two is the valacula. Okay, now in the midline there is median glosso epiglottic fold, and on other side there are two lateral glosso epiglottic folds. See this, if I draw larynx, laryngeal cavity little bit below, you can clearly make out the lateral glosso epiglottic folds over here. So in between these three glosso epiglottic fold, one median and two lateral, these depressions are termed as valacula. Now just see the continuity of epiglottis. Okay, so this is the laryngeal inlet. Now this fold, see this, this fold is termed as airy epiglottic fold. It extends from apex of arytenoid cartilage to the side of the epiglottis, airy epiglottic fold, and you can clearly make out some bulge or some props. These are produced by underlying corniculate and cuneiform cartilages. These are elastic cartilages. Say this. Now on either side of this airy epiglottic fold over here, you can see a depression. This is pyriform fossa. So obviously its medial boundary is airy epiglottic fold, whereas its lateral boundary is formed by the medial surface of lamina of thyroid cartilage and thyrohyoid membrane. So what we have seen from in front, over here you can see this is the lamina of thyroid cartilage, so this is its lateral surface or external surface, and over here will be the internal surface or medial surface of the cartilage, thyroid cartilage, and above to that you can clearly make out that this is the upper limit of thyroid cartilage, and this is the greater cornu of hyoid bone. So in between these two is the thyrohyoid membrane, and obviously the same thyrohyoid membrane will form lateral boundary of pyriform fossa. Over here you can see, okay, see this. So over here, this is, this will be the thyrohyoid membrane. Now here it is covered by mucous membrane. Okay, just a thin layer you can see which is being moved, a soft looking whitish membrane is the mucous membrane. Okay, so the entire pyriform fossa is covered by mucous membrane. So obviously the airy epiglottic fold, the lamina of thyroid cartilage and thyroid membrane, everything is covered by this mucous membrane. Above it is limited by this lateral glosso epiglottic fold. So this is the territory of pyriform fossa. Posteriorly it is open, and some important thing about pyriform fossa is that along its lateral wall deep to the mucous membrane, the internal laryngeal nerve and superior laryngeal vessels will enter over here in the pharynx. Okay, so if some object which is having very sharp edge, if it gets stuck over here, it can damage this internal laryngeal nerve. And as you know, internal laryngeal nerve is carrying sensations or sensory, it is providing sensory innervation to the laryngeal cavity above vocal cord. So the cough reflex particularly will get disturbed and patient can aspirate the object or aspirate the fluid. So that is situated over here, internal laryngeal nerve deep to this mucous membrane. Now regarding laryngeal cavity, this is the laryngeal inlet and deep inside will be the laryngeal cavity, which is subdivided into three parts. Above false vocal cord, that portion is termed as vestibule of the larynx. Between false and true vocal cord, that portion is termed as sinus of the larynx. And below true vocal cord to the lower border of cricoid cartilage, that is termed as infraglottic compartment. So the entire cavity is divided into three compartments: vestibule, sinus of larynx and infraglottic compartment. Plus you will also see false vocal cord and true vocal cords inside the cavity. Now to visualize the laryngeal cavity, let me insert an endoscope and then I will show you how the true vocal cord and cavity of larynx looks like. Now next view will be from the endoscope. See, this is how it looks like. In the center you can see the epiglottis, above there are vallecula, and below and behind the epiglottis you can see two airy epiglottic folds. In their lower part these folds are bulged because of underlying corniculate and cuneiform cartilages. So this is how the laryngeal inlet looks like, and when we see through it, in the center you can see two longitudinal folds, these are vocal cords. Okay, and the space between this vocal cord is termed as rima glottidis. Now when we go further above to these vocal cords, you can see two similar folds, these are the false vocal cords or vestibular folds. And when we go through this rima glottidis or the space between two vocal cords, below there will be infraglottic compartment. And still below, beyond the lower border of the cricoid cartilage, you will able to see the tracheal rings. See over here, you can see in anterior aspect there are C-shaped tracheal rings. So beyond C6, the trachea commences. So this is how the laryngeal cavity looks from inside. Now in another specimen, this posterior wall of the larynx is cut and you can clearly see the entire laryngeal cavity from behind. See this. So this is the same epiglottis, and if I close it like this, so this is how it is oriented. Once we cut open this from behind, this is how it looks like. So this is epiglottis, you can clearly make out that it is a leaf shaped cartilage, elastic cartilage. And over here will be the laryngeal inlet with airy epiglottic fold. Now these two are the false vocal cords and these are the true vocal cords. So in between false and true vocal cords, this is the sinus of larynx. Now below to this true vocal cords, this portion is the infraglottic compartment, and above to the false vocal cord, this is the vestibule of larynx. Okay, now still below you can clearly make out the tracheal rings. So this is the trachea, which commences from lower margin of or lower border of cricoid cartilage. So this is how it looks like from behind. So this is regarding laryngeal cavity. Hope you have understood well. Thanks for watching.